Yes, assalamu alaikum dear students. This time I again welcome you to lecture number 8 on differential equations. We are continuing with the solution of first order and first degree differential equations by different methods. First we took the variable separable method, then gradually we have reached the homogeneous differential equations, how we solve the homogeneous differential equations. And today we have some differential equations which are reducible to homogeneous form. Some differential equations which are not homogeneous, but at the same time we can reduce them to homogeneous differential equations. Let us introduce this in this way. If we consider a differential equation, consider a differential equation in fact it is a linear first order, because we are dealing with linear first order. It is dy by dx is equal to a1x plus b1y plus c1 upon a2x plus b2y plus c2. This is your differential equation, first order and first degree. You see, if this c1 would have not been here, c1 and c2, suppose this was not here, what was this differential equation? It was a homogeneous of first order, first degree. It was homogeneous, a1x plus b1y plus a2x plus b2y. We then directly could go by the method y is equal to vx and so on. But here when you have this c1 and c2, due to the presence of c1 and c2, this differential equation ceases to be now homogeneous. It is not homogeneous. So it is obvious, if we want to transform this differential equation into a homogeneous form, then use the homogeneous method, I have to get rid of this c1 and c2. If I get rid of this c1 and c2, I write this differential equation free of the constant. Sometimes you may have constant only in the numerator, sometimes you have only in the denominator, sometimes you may come across a constant both in the numerator and denominator. If such differential equation is, where you find differential equation is of this form, whatever a1, b1, a2, b2 is, but here existence of constant either in the numerator or in the denominator or in the both makes it a non-homogeneous, it is not a homogeneous. But at the same time, such differential equation, we say it is reducible to homogeneous form. Now, we have here to reduce this differential equation to transform differential equation first into homogeneous form. We want to convert this into homogeneous form. We have to check, there are two types of this, two cases arise. Case number one that we deal here is, if a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. What is your a1 coefficient of x in the numerator? What is your a2 coefficient of x in the denominator? Becomes the fraction a1 by a2. This is coefficient of y in the numerator, coefficient of y in the denominator b2 is b1. If this is different, these do not coincide, these are not same, then we apply a method known as this variable transformation method. Then we use change of variable method. Remember this, when these are not equal, this is change of variable method we go. change of variable method. How we do it? We introduce new variables. We write let our x be equal to alpha plus h, and we take y is equal to beta plus k, small k. Well, in some books you may come across small x is equal to capital X plus h, small y is equal to capital Y plus k. That is also correct. There capital X and capital Y are new variables. Here, to avoid the confusion, I am using alpha and beta, where alpha and beta are now new variables, where alpha and beta are variables. These are the variables, new variable, because we are applying change of variable method. What is h and k? And h and k are constants. These are constants to be chosen suitably. We choose these constants suitably, to be chosen suitably. Remember this, that this h and k are constants. These are at your disposal. We choose them in such a way that it satisfies our requirement, to be chosen suitably. You will see later on how we choose it. So this is the method. When a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, there are only two ways. Either this is not equal, or second case is when this is equal to this. Now you see how we go. When you write this, your x is alpha plus small h, y is beta plus k. I can write dx by differential rule. Dx is equal to d alpha, because alpha is also a variable, function of x or y. D beta I will write here, dy, it is d beta. H is constant, k is constant, it is derivative to 0. Therefore, this will give me dy by dx will be equal to d of beta by d of alpha. So using this in given differential equation, I use it in first. That was my dy by dx. What was first? Dy by dx is equal to a1 x plus b1 y plus c1 by a2x plus b2y plus c2. I am using this here. When I use it here, what this give me? This is your d beta by d alpha is equal to your a1 is, this you have put alpha plus h plus b1 is beta plus k, value of y I am using, plus c1 by, this is a2, again alpha plus h plus b2 beta plus k, the value of y I am giving, plus c2. Now arrange this, it is d beta by d alpha is equal to, this will be your a1 alpha b1 beta. I am writing the constant a1 alpha b, then you have plus here a1 h plus b1 k plus c1, division by, take this a2 alpha plus b2 beta, then write the constant set a2h plus b2 k plus c2. This is equation number second. Now I have already told you that h and k are at our disposal. These are constants. We give the values to h and k so that this portion and this portion becomes simultaneously zero. We can make it by giving the value to h and k, so that when this vanishes here, you get this part only, a1 alpha plus b1 beta, a2 alpha plus b2 beta, then this becomes homogeneous by our transformation for this method, change of variable method, and in change of variable we choose the constants in such a way that becomes zero. Now we choose h and k such that, because we have already told you that there is a suitable choice for h and k, we choose h and k such that a1h plus b1k plus c1 is 0, then a2h plus b2k plus c2 becomes 0 simultaneously. Now we solve these for h and k, because we have to find out the h and k in such a way that this becomes 0, this becomes 0. How we find out this value of h and k? I solve it by cross multiply method. You see how your a1h plus b1k plus c1 is 0. Here you have a2h plus b2k plus c2 is 0. This is your h. By cross multiply, solve simultaneously by cross multiply method. We solve these simultaneously, because they should simultaneously become 0 for the value of h and k. By how you solve by cross multiply method, it is h, determinant rule I am using, k 1. You close this, you write here it is b1, b2, c1, c2. Then by your method, you close this part, you write here, go from right, c1, c2, a1. A2, as you do in lower classes. Then you close this part, coefficients you write, coefficient of h here, this is a1 a2 b1 b2. This is cross multiply method you have done in your previous classes. Close this part, write the coefficients of variables, that is b1 b2, it is here c1 c2. Then close this part, go from right, c1 c2 here, then coefficient of variables a1 a2 and so on. This gives you h by cross multiply, this determinant rule I'm here, b1 c2 minus b2 c1, then it is equal to k by c1 a2 minus a2 a1 c2. This is your 1 by, well, this is a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Now when you solve this, taking this with this, this gives me h is, what is h? It is b1 c2 minus b2 c1 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is my value of h. When I take this and this, this is k is equal to, take second and last ratio, when you take second and last ratio, it is c1 a2 minus a1 c2 by again a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This gives me k. Yes, by cross multiply method, take first and second, first and last, it gives h is equal to this. Take second and last, it gives k is equal to c1 a2 minus a1 c2 by a1 b2 minus a2 b1. By cross multiply method, I find out h and k. Now this value of h and k is such that it will make this simultaneously 0, this and this is 0. So using this value of h and k in second, using this value of h and k in second, using value of h and k in equation number second, you get d beta by d alpha is what now? a1 alpha plus b1 beta by a2 alpha plus b2 beta. Because you have found out the value of h and k in such a way that these two terms simultaneously become 0. Now what is this equation now? This is homogeneous, obviously. This is a homogeneous differential equation of first degree. Well, it is now your homogeneous differential equation. How you go now? Well, it is a homogeneous. In case of homogeneous differential equation, when dy by dx is equal to homogeneous form, we put y is equal to vx. So therefore, we put here your y is beta is equal to v alpha. V is also have some function, variable function. So this gives d beta by d alpha is v plus alpha dv by d alpha. Using in third, you get v plus alpha dv by d alpha is equal to, this is your a1 alpha plus b1 v alpha by a2 alpha plus b2 v alpha. Now this becomes apply here variable separable method. It obviously can solve you by variable separable method. Suppose you get, then say we get here, we assume here we get this integral of some function of f of alpha d alpha. This side we get integral of some function, say it is g of here to g of v dv, because it is in alpha and v. One side you will get functions of alpha d alpha, other side functions of v with dv. I assume that this takes this integral form. So when you integrate this, you get this, say it is psi 1 alpha plus this is psi 2 say v plus c. This is the solution. But what is now your alpha and v you have to replace. You have to replace this. When you replace alpha, it takes psi 1 alpha is equal to psi 2 beta plus c. I am supposing here. Why I am supposing? Because I am using v is equal to beta. V is beta by alpha I am using here. So my equation will be now only in alpha and beta. I have to replace alpha by its value. What is alpha? It is psi is equal to alpha. You have put what was your alpha there from the starting change of variables. You put there x is equal to alpha plus h, y is equal to beta plus k. So what is your alpha now? Alpha will be x minus h is equal to psi 2 is beta is y minus k plus c. This is the solution, and you have to use h and k, the value that you have found. So you get the solution in terms of only x and y. When this differential equation was not homogeneous, there was the existence of constants c1 and c2, and we could make it homogeneous by suitable transformation. When it satisfies the case a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Now there is second case, that is a very simple case, when it takes the form a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. There we apply the method of common factor method we have there. You see that case also. Well, students, we have case number second. It is simple one. Case second, when a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. Our first case was a1 by a2 not equal to b1. Now we have a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. We solve the given differential equation by common factor. You get here a common factor in this case, common factor method. It is a common factor method. We assume, say, a1 by a2 is b1 by b2, I will assume it 1 by m, say. Assuming this 1 by m. So when you assume it 1 by m, you can get a1 by a2, or simply you can assume m. If you assume m, you will get the value of a1 in terms of a2, b1 in terms of b2. You can do that way also. It is 1 by m. b1 by b2 is 1 by m. So this gives my a2 is m times a1. This gives my b2 is m times b1. So what was my differential equation? My differential equation was dy by dx. Initially, it was a1x plus b1y plus c1 by a2x plus b2y plus c2. This was a differential equation, but it satisfies this condition: a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. I use this substitution. This is your a1 x plus b1y plus c1. I am using a2 in terms of this. This is now ma1 into x. This is mb1 into y plus c1. So my differential equation becomes dy by dx is equal to, this is the factor, a1x plus b1y plus c1. This is your, taking m common, this is again a1x plus b1y plus c2. It is c2, sorry. This is c2 there, c2. This is c2. We are using common factor method. You see, in this case, you have got a common factor here, this one. This is now very simple to solve. In this case, how we go? So in this case, what we do is we put a1x plus b1y is equal to, say, z. What is this now? Differentiate with respect to x, both sides. a1 plus b1 dy by dx is equal to dz by dx. This gives me b1 dy by dx is dz by dx minus a1. That means dy by dx is 1 by b1 times dz by dx minus a1. Use in second equation, then variables separable method. You use this in second equation, then variable separable method, and finally, actually, when you apply here variable separable method, you use this dy by dx in this, you will get this equation number second. You see here, this will be your 1 by b1 dz by dx minus a. This will be your z. You have put this z plus c1, mz plus c2. So this differential equation will be now in x and z. Then use variable method for x and z. When you use variable separable method, then finally the differential equation, the solution will involve z. It will be, the solution will be in terms of x and z. The solution of this differential equation, when it is capable of putting in the variable separable method, this solution will involve x and z. But your z is what? Your z was a1x plus b1y. Finally, you put z as a1x plus b1y. You have the solution. This is very simple. The second case, when it takes the form that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. When it takes the form a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, then there is a little bit labor that involves in the solution. The solution becomes a little bit lengthy, but in second case it is very simple when it becomes the common factor method. Let me have some applications on this. We have described here in detail how do we solve the differential equations when they take the form non-homogeneous, but at the same time they seem to be reducible to homogeneous form. let me take some application form. Application. I am having a differential equation. Suppose solve the differential equation. Solve differential equation. It is 2 times x plus y dy, 2 times x plus y dy is equal to 1 minus 3x minus 3y, 1 minus 3x minus 3y dx. This is the differential equation that I want to solve. You can write this differential equation as, this is dy by dx is equal to 1 minus 3x minus 3y by 2x plus 2y. This I can write further as minus 3x minus 3y plus 1 by 2x plus 2y. Well, you see here, this differential equation is such that the existence of this constant makes it non-homogeneous. If this constant would have not been here, it was a homogeneous differential equation. But due to the presence of constant here, or here also, or in either in numerator or in denominator, this is reducible to homogeneous form. This is now, this differential equation is, it is reducible to homogeneous ordinary differential equation. Let us see what is here A1. We check what is our A1 by A2. Your A1 is coefficient of x in the numerator, that is minus 3. Your A2 is coefficient of x in the denominator, is 2, minus 3 by 2. What is your B1 by B2? It is coefficient of y in the numerator, that is minus 3 again. Coefficient of y in the denominator is 2. Oh yes, you are seeing there A1 by A2 is equal to what? B1 by B2. This case is applicable. So we apply which method? Second method. What was that? That was known as common factor. This is done by common factor method. This can be solved now by common factor method, because we are getting this rule is satisfied even by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. How we go? We can rewrite this differential equation second. Second implies now this, it is dy by dx is equal to, I will write it, minus 3 out, it is x plus y, then plus 1 in the denominator, you have 2 times x plus y. You have a common factor here. What is common factor? It is x plus y. This is the common factor, x plus y here, x plus y here. It is our second equation. I will name it second. You put x plus y is equal to z. Put x plus y is equal to z. Differentiate. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. This is 1 plus dy by dx. It is dz by dx. Okay? Dz by dx. This gives me dy by dx is equal to what? Dz by dx minus 1. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Now use this in second. Use in second equation. When I use it in second, what it gives? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Okay, I will use it here. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is minus 3, x plus y is z, plus 1, it is 2z. Now you can make this variable separable method, and remember that our x plus y is z. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. this is your dz minus 3z plus 1 by 2z plus 1. Okay, la havla wala quwwata illa billah. It is minus 3z plus 1 plus 2z by 2z. I am simplifying this. I hope you are following my this dz by dx. La havla wala quwwata illa billah. This is your minus z plus 1 by 2z. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Variables are separable. Variables are now separable. It is La ilaha illallah. One, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Muhammadin. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama barakta رزيد بالله ربا ومحمد رسول ابي اسلام دينا صلى الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now this is variable separable, you can write it. It is twice integral of z dz by, I will write it as z minus 1 here. Where goes this minus? I will write it minus here, minus integral of 1 dx plus c. Okay, I took minus here common so that I could write it z minus 1. So this minus I took here. Now how I integrate this one? You see, this is degree of numerator as degree of denominator. It is known as improper fraction. Here you actually divide or you make the constants in the numerator and denominator same and then go ahead. There are two ways. Well, you can write this integral as, it is twice integral or I will write it z minus 1 plus 1 by z minus 1 dz is minus x plus c. I can go this way also. This is twice integral of, separate the integral, z minus 1 by z minus 1 dz, then plus 2 integral of 1 by z minus 1 dz is equal to minus x plus c. Now you know we had here only z by z minus 1. There are two ways. One is to divide the numerator by denominator, or second is when you find a constant here, add the same constant here and then add and subtract so that to make this equal to this, then split it. It is the method that you know how to solve such integrals. This is simply now twice integral of 1 dz. This is plus twice, what is this? It is f dash by fx. Derivative of this is this with respect to z. It is log of denominator, log of z minus 1 is equal to minus x plus c. Now use the value z is equal to x plus y. This gives twice z plus 2 log of z minus 1 is equal to minus x plus c. This is 2 times x plus y plus twice log of x plus y minus 1 is equal to minus x plus c. Now what is the solution? It is 2x, this x goes here, it is 3x, 2x plus this x is here, 3x plus 2y plus 2 times log of x plus y minus 1 is equal to c. This is the solution of this differential equation, which was not homogeneous, but it was reducible to homogeneous form. At the same time, it took second case, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. We applied common factor method. Now we will also do some more problems where a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. I will show you how to do those different. This case are simple. Where you come across such differential equations where a1 by a2 is b1 by b2, it is very simple. Make the common factor, put common factor, you will certainly get there a common factor if the differential equations of this form, put that equal to z, new variable, and it converts this variable to separable method, then give the back value to z. This is the solution in x and y of this differential equation. We will be meeting again we will solve some more differential equations which are reducible to homogeneous form. I hope you are following the lectures, you are doing the this remaining questions at your places from different books, and that will help you. Here we are also showing you some typical question problems so that you can do the other problems very easily. Thank you very much. See you next in next lecture.